Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to Bioshock 2 in our Let's Replay series where we try to delve a bit deeper into an, well, somewhat older game, Bioshock 2. We're at Fontaine Futuristics and I think there's a special kind of camera in this office. And we're trying to enter this security office over here. And we have the voice module of Gil Alexander, the boss of this area, in our possession, so that shouldn't be a problem now, should it?
Please see password to enter.
I warned you. When you're down in the mountain, life's a pain. Weatherman says heavy rain, but it's still a boost is all you need. Average Joe to Hercules. Stronger arm and sharper brain, that's why the future is haunted.
Please speak clearly. Automatic deactivation for 60 seconds.
Oh, he's jamming the voice print lock with that awful crooning. See if you can find some way to sabotage his control of building security.
So there we go, using his invincible security bolt.
Okay. The security office is well above your pay grade. If you're so keen to help, the restrooms need a good scrub. Here's a clerk or two to help you along.
Oh, shit. There we go, that's one. And I can't use... I could swear in the previous version of this game, I was able to pull out spears from the wall, but apparently that doesn't happen in this version. I could swear that I could do that. Okay, I'm out of place for the spears, and there we have our next big daddy to deal with. So we can't open the security office because Alexander the Great would block that with his invincible security bot, because you can't kill it. So we need to find a way to disable his control over the security bots, so we can just play the voice module over here and enter the security office. So, multi-tiered tasks ahead, but first, means of control.
Prison, it seems, was a blessing. Brian is now dead by his own son's hand. But far more interesting is the program of compulsion bred into his child, coded WYK. It was some manner of verbal trigger phrase, which the boy would obey as an order, unerringly. In a way, this sad thing, this half-man, had escaped the self. Highly intelligent, but devoid of so-called free will, with all its convenient blind spots. What if he had been instructed to uphold the common good? What if he were a volunteer?
I think you should check the definition of volunteer, as in, I'm doing this out of my own free will. And since Jack Ryan didn't have any free will left, that's kind of a moot point, but... let's try and kill this Big Daddy first. Oh, I'm done with research on Big Daddies then. Oh, never mind then. Heavy rivets for now, and let's just... oh, let's set the man on fire. No, you know what? The rivets will probably do that. No, wait, they won't. Let's go with telekinesis. There we go. Timing.
Time out. You gotta time out.
Oh. And there he goes. Heavy rivets for the win. Rumbler down, two rocket spears, $49 and another mini turret, and our first little sister of the level. Well, you were crying for that monster just a few seconds ago, but hey, get up on my shoulder and we'll see what we can get around here. I could get those heavy rivets, thank you. I'm starting to get really lazy. I think in real life I would also be very lazy if I had access to telekinesis. I would just be a fucking bore. Let's see, 265 Adam. And we have the last levels of the plasmids. Electrobolt 3, Incinerate 3, Insect Swarm 2 and 3. Ooh, we have a lot of stuff to take into account. E-Saver 2, that's something I want to invest in. So let's take that already. Damage Research, not, I want to keep that. So for now, let's remove the other Eve Saver and do it like that. Landing in a blue bonus zone ends a hack instantly. That would be interesting. I'm gonna keep the rest as it is for now, because I'll probably wanna invest into one of the last level plasmids instead of anything else. Maybe one Gene Tonic slot to get that E Saver back in my or Arms Race. Let's keep that for now. We'll see how that works. And yeah. So we have a few areas we can explore around here. Over here we have the plasmid showroom. I think on the left there's a bunch of offices. Or no, the bathrooms, the bathrooms. And there's, what's this? Employees only. So I don't think, can I actually enter this already? Oh, I can. Well, let's go here. And then I think over there is the plasmid laboratory. And upstairs are the offices, if I'm not mistaken. So let's head over here on the left first. And or you know what, I don't think this is probably the way out, if I'm remembering correctly. Yeah, okay, so it's locked. Okay,
unzip him, daddy.
There we go, a few headshots. I'm not stuck, game. I'm not stuck, I'm just exploring a bit. So this is probably the way out, so don't really need to be here. Let's check out the bathrooms as usual. Should actually want to, yeah, let's hack this thing. There we go. And let's just heal.
Yes, congratulations. You've won a battle of wits with a home appliance.
And there we go. Alex the Great, well, congratulating us. Not really the right word, probably, but laughing at our feet that we just hacked an help. Oh, hi. Nope, goodbye. Why did you... Did I set that on fire with the heavy rivet? Well, the normal rivet... yeah, that was a Houdini spice. It might have been that she set that on fire. I can't open this one up like I could in Bioshock 1. So that's a bit of a downgrade. That's a bit of a downgrade, 2K. Gonna hack this. I could. Yes. Okay, there we go. And another frag grenade. Thank you very much. We do have a lot of money, so I might as well just check around a bit. Maybe a few grenades, solid stocks, and phosphorus buck. There we go. Make a bit of room for all the other bits of money we're gonna come across. And then the arrow points us towards the plasmid laboratory, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it does.
Don't you dare touch that signal relay, Delta. Its value is 10 times your own.
There we go. You can either destroy them manually, but you can shoot at them as well.
Delta, destruction of a Fontaine asset is punishable by summary dismissal. Shall I simplify that for you? Fired! Fired! Fired!
Sounds like Donald Trump is on the phone. You're fired! Oh, wait. Get out of my way, get out of my way. There we go. Thank you very much.
I know what you're up to. You're after my job, aren't you? With your background? Do you know what class of person we chose for the Alpha series? Criminals, Delta. You'll be laughed out of the boardroom, out of the city!
So there we go, what class of people we chose to become the Alpha series? Criminals.
I think you're onto something, kid. Some kind of pirate relay doohickey keeping security under his spell. Find the rest of those and vandalize them directly.
That kind of stuck in a security bot, so Sinclair being Captain Obvious for a bit. We need to find all those relays, destroy them, and that should destroy the control that Gil Alexander has. And this is also very interesting. So, Alexander the Great mentioned that his they used criminals to become the Alpha series. Which is interesting, because we know we're someone who came in from on top. So we're not really a criminal.
The power of the gods is yours. All of our procedures are quick, painless, and safe.
Quick, painless, and safe. Not what
Gee, thanks,
I have
Doc.
Seen.
I feel amazing. Never felt
felt better.
Oh, wow. God.
The results are clear. Invest today in plasmid technology.
Well, that demonstration didn't go well, because she's tied to a bed and stabbed with Eve hypos. Where the hell did those heat-seeking rockets come from? Were they over there already? Kind of missed those. I am blind, apparently. Trap rivets. Was there someone? Oh, there's someone. There we go.
This pine shelter. Take it.
Goodbye.
Take it all.
So yeah, because of the fire damage, we can take out splices really, really quickly, apparently. Didn't think that would go that fast. And of course, with the headhunter tonic. So yeah, let's take a look around. I will start our run through Fontaine Futuristics in the Plasmid showroom. Hello. That was nice with confetti and everything. Help me. 5254. Let's remember that. Help me. 5254. There's someone over there. Let's hack this thing. Okay. This is going pretty fast already.
I designed that device, Delta. You fumble at it like an amorous baboon.
Maybe I am an amorous baboon. Hello? Why don't you just die? Thank you very much. Let's take all their loot. Thank you very much. And then maybe, since we're using those all the time, our rivets, let's swap over back to the shotgun. So employees only, please wait to be seated, because this is a very, very cool area. So this is the Plasmid Theater. And why it's called that? Well, it's kind of obvious, of course. But we're gonna see that in a minute, because this area has a special connection to Subject Delta, to us. And there's a few, well, interesting things in this area as well. Let's first put a spear in her head. And then I'm gonna... There we go. There we go. It didn't even have the time to shoot at me, apparently. There's a few of these interesting machines inside of this area. So, for example, this one is the incinerate tester. And that just lights that and just that oil slick here as well. And I think, is this already the... Yeah, 5254. So let's head in there immediately so we can help that poor woman that's probably been dead for years by now. Over here, do I need to crouch? Apparently I do. So this is the one we saw. Ooh, that is a very nice crate. Prototype.
Our hope was to bond a little sister to a single protector, so she had to be expendable in case of error. As we were fabricating a father bond, we couldn't really afford to have the girl's parents asking around. So Fontaine's orphanages provided. And the procedure was an unprecedented success. If I had only known who the child was, Eleanor, I'm so sorry.
So Gil Alexander, realizing that the first little sister they were successful in bonding with a big daddy was actually Eleanor, and of course regretting it because he really likes Sophia Lam and her ideas. Let's take this lovely thing. The Careful Hacker 2 tonic. So take your time with Careful Hacker 2. Machines will all move more slowly, giving you plenty of time to subvert their inner workings. I don't think I used the normal Careful Hacker, so I'm not going to use that for now. Just so we can save up on a few bits of ammo. So until we have enough ammo spared up, saved up. I'm going to keep Arms Race equipped instead of anything else. So first aid kit, we haven't been damaged lately. And then Electrobolt. Ta-ta-ta-ta! I love these machines. The little additions, and you can only see them over here. But it's actually really cool. Really nicely done. So, let's gather this corpse. I'm gonna put down a few traps. Especially very interesting with these ones over here. So, give me a second. So, I think that should do. Put down a few cyclone traps, and I actually put a few over here on the walls, etc. as well, so let's see how that works out. Now, shall we put you down over here? And then let's see what happens. I'm just gonna take the rivet gun, because they're gonna be far off in every direction, if I'm not mistaken. So here we go. I think I could, this is a pretty manageable position. There we go. Because, well, we have those traps all over the place. And then the water, which will stop anybody from coming close to her. Is no one going to come from the other side? Oh, that might. Or maybe that was the one over there. What is that? Ooh, that's an Alpha Series. So, hello, sir. There we go. Increased ammo carrying capacity. Goodbye, Delta. Well, it's not Delta, but it's me, kind of. Yep. Bye. Are you dead? Think you're dead. Are they fighting each other? There we go. Let's pick her up. Don't know what was... There was something wrong with her. Ooh, what happened to the health station? Sorry for that. Where's the... I saw Houdini Splicer. Would have been very nice to meet him. Just so I could relieve him from his loot. But apparently he didn't care. So everybody over here died, which is good, of course. It's exactly what we wanted. Okay. Ah, for fuck's sake. I'm stuck. Boom. Goodbye. Goodbye. What the fuck was that? Did I just get damaged from the fire? Probably did. And I love the jazz music in the background. Kind of soothing. Very, very... Ooh, fragmenting. Thank you very much. I think I'm gonna start using the grenade launcher a bit more. Because I have a lot of fragmenting. Let's pick up my... Because nobody apparently came this way. Most of my trap rivets were in this way, and my traps on the walls. Come on. Oh well. If anybody tries to follow me this way, they're gonna. I think he's gonna explode, right? Yeah, there he goes. Because this keeps throwing out stuff. Oh, I can add all the. Ooh, yeah, because of the upgrade we just found. Because we
Hopeless underperformer can be employee of the month. Or you should know. Look around. Is any of this familiar?
Of course it is. So, yeah.
The consumer is indebted to you, my boy. We ironed kink after kink out of our domestic plasmid line on you right here. Well, let's see if you're staying competitive. Step on up and take the spotlight.
There you go, that's what I think about your mic. I'm dropping it. So yeah, this is the theater where they showed investors the new plasmids. And Delta was the test subject in this case.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fontaine Futuristics invites you to shed your skepticism, evolve your expectations, and dissolve your doubt as we unveil the revolutionary power of our home defense plasmid series.
Yay, applause, although everybody in the audience is dead. Everybody's dead, so.
Don't be shy.
He needs a volunteer, but he's not finding any.
No, he's positively rigid.
Yeah, rigid because he's dead. Yeah, laughing.
Oh, come on now. Let's give it a hand, folks.
And now we have a splicer. I'm just gonna take a picture of her. Hello? And then I should be able to just blast her.
Only a single volunteer.
And then electrobolt now, the gentlemen. Water. Oh, there is no electrobolt here. God damn it. God damn it. Bees! Bees! And a spear through her face. And now we have this guy.
Oh,
And another one. And that should take care of him. Oh, is he? Oh, he's getting annoyed by the... Oh, come on. Select the drill already. Where did he go? You know what? I got one of those tricks. There we go. Fireball back in your face. There we go. And then the next one. Buffoon. There you go. Thank you very much, thank you. So this must have been a painful memory for Delta.
Oh,
but now.
Subject Delta? It looks like you've upstaged a fellow demonstrator and he's here to steal the show. What will Delta do now, folks?
I'm just gonna murderize his ass. Because I've got a surprise for you. And there we go. And then he runs into the water. Boom! There we go. Kind of dropped down there, but yeah, I don't take electricity damage. Oh, that echo was a bit annoying, but there we go. That's 2 out of 4. And we've got another area done. So the Plasmid Theater, where Subject Delta was, subjected to some horrible, horrible demonstrations, as they call it right here. So let's see if there's anything I can. I think I can take that. Yeah, proximity mine with me. Can I actually auto-hack? Oh, I can. Is that now? Huh. Interesting. Didn't even know you could do that. Because, well, you usually don't have to do that. But yeah, I just wanted to try that out. Heating rockets, thank you very much. Didn't use any shotgun shells, and there's nothing really behind this destroyed door either. So, with that done, let's head to our next area. This guy. Oh! That was something else. Still have one of my spears, though. Thank you. So, let's head out and head towards the next area, because we're round towards the entrance again, so where we entered this area. Let's see. There are more splicers in here. Where the hell...
Gotta change it up.
Yeah, indeed. You gotta change it up, so that's why I'm using the shotgun at the moment.
I'm being what exactly?
Finish your sentence, sir. God damn it. Life after sisterhood.
This is Eleanor Lamb speaking. It's been many years since my last diary. Mother found a way to rehabilitate me psychologically. But she can't remove this thing inside my body. I look in the mirror, and I see a freak. I remember very little. Just an artificial sense of peace and a compulsive hunger for Adam. Dr. Alexander is trying to help me adjust. He's responsible for part of my condition, but he wants to make amends.
He wants to make amends. So that's the older Eleanor, the Eleanor we've been talking to so far. And yeah, she's experiencing the fact that little sisters become very aggressive when they grow up. And yeah, she didn't handle that very good. I'm gonna try something new. So I'm gonna put the cyclone traps on the walls, and that way they should push the enemy inside of these proximity mines. If they don't just trigger them already, of course. So that would be... That's going to be very fun. Lots and lots of fun. So one over here. One over there. And then just put a few proximity mines over here. The reason why I'm doing this is because I'm... I have a lot of proximity mines at the moment. Don't really know what to do with them for now, so I'm just gonna use them. Anything else? I should probably take care of this side as well. Ooh, this might be a very nice one. Just put one over here. And then at the top of the stairs, if they come from over there, we're gonna be in for a surprise. So over there, and then one over here. Oh! I just booby-trapped that shotgun. That's interesting. Didn't even know that could happen. Well, goodbye, dear shotgun trap. There we go, and then maybe a few simple cyclone traps around the body. Just around here. Just in case they're still coming too close. Not that that will happen, I think. They're gonna be pretty dead if they manage to get over here. And then one on top of the body, just in case. And just electrobolt it. And this one could go with an incineration. There we go. I think that's pretty well defended. So I can get these proximity mines back. Reload that quickly. And just use the normal grenades on anything that just gets close enough. Nope, don't. Oh, I can't pick up that one actually. Gather Adam. So this corpse, for some reason, had a lot of proximity mines. Ooh, I can actually go in here. That's a nice way of protecting myself. Just let's just use the shotgun. Oh shit. Oh. There we go. Ooh, she exploded. I think she exploded. Jesus Christ, this is not a good position. Are they gonna... So he's gonna throw another one of those. That's something, but where are they going? Yeah, bye. How the hell? That's a shotgun, you know. You don't do a lot of damage from over there. There's one over there as well, but. There we go. That's the last one. So let's pick her up. And I set up all those drops for nothing, because all there was were... God damn it, can I pick this back up? Oh, I can, yes, of course. Should have been talking... Hello? No? No, so these exploded. I should take a picture of the turret that's apparently... around here. Oh, God. Thank you. A plus. That's my turret now. Could have used that in the battle as well, but... Any other proximity mines I can pick back up? This one didn't explode either, so that's very, very handy. And then... And then... So there's a lot of other areas here. So I was kind of right, so these are the offices upstairs. But first, let's rescue our little sister, of course. And then we're gonna take a look in some of these offices. There we go.
Thank you.
Goodbye. That could help. We could go inside of the hole I hit in. Thank you for the proximity mine. Let's see what else is around here. Seems like there's nothing behind the pipes. But this should lead somewhere.
Looks upon the world, saying, all of this is...
Oh shit. There we go. That'll do it for us.
Him alone. For the tyrant, even justice is whimsy. He alone is fit to weigh, to measure, and to count.
So there we go. Another bit of rambling from Sophia Lamb. talking about the tyrant instead of the parasite, which is really, really interesting, because her chants almost sound exactly like Andrew Ryan, except for the fact that she's talking about tyrants instead of parasites. And again, I don't know what Bioshock's obsession is with dead cats, but a lot of cat food and a dead cat again. But now we can actually go inside of the area that has the demonstration with the woman that was tied to the bed, if you remember. Because this is the way to enter that, but I think, if I'm not mistaken, these rocket spears, thank you very much. Might come in handy against the next big daddy, but I think there's a camera here. Or maybe not, I could be mistaken, and apparently I am. So this is one of those gatherable corpses, but I do need the Eve hypos that are strewn around this area, and a new cognitive model.
This calls everything into question. Even as I recall this, I can scarcely believe. Psychiatry has been my continual study, to chart consciousness in all its strata. But intelligence does not require introspection. The son of Ryan was more effective than all his self-aware rivals. He lived without questions. I could end the self and save the world.
I could end the self and save the world. So again, Sophia Lamb is really impressed with what Jack Ryan could do without his free will, although she's blatantly ignoring that the second half of the game, well, the latter half of the game, he did have his free will. And now we have Drill Power 2. Prefer punch-ups to shoot-outs? With Drill Power 2, you'll be a master of melee. So, of course, we're going to swap that out for our normal Drill Power. And then that starts again. And I think that's the reason. So now these guys enter the fray. I'm just gonna put myself on the side here and just electro-bolt my own place. I think I am going to do that. Because these guys are now really, really damaged. And I think the one over there is also dead, yeah. Because our electro-bolt is pretty powerful at the moment. So, now we have a way out again, because these guys just, thankfully blew open the window for us. Let's heal that. And then...
the cause has no need of a lummox.
There we go. That's all for us. And now we're back in the lower area. So we've been to the Plasmid Laboratory. We can't go over there on the left. And we've been to the Plasma Theater as well. So everything on the first floor is done. So, and with that, I'm going to take a little break while we head upstairs, because that will have to wait for until the next personnel round, the next episode. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. If you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. And with that, yeah, thank you guys enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.